Welcome students. In the lecture series of digital system design, after the completion of the number system and the general definition of logic gates and binary system, now we are moved to the another unit. It's called as a Boolean algebra and logic gates. A Boolean algebra, it is like as a other deductive mathematical system. It may be defined with a set of element. There is a different as per the mathematical definition, it is a set of element it is a set of operator and a number unapproved axioms or postulates. Unproved number of unproved axioms or postulate. Now here, a set of element is any collection of object having a common property. If S is a set of element and X and Y are certain object, this is a set of element, X and Y are certain objects, S is set object, then X is denoted as the X is the number of set S. Okay. And Y is not element of X, suppose if it is written like as this. So it is not a element of S. And X is element. Okay. Similarly, sometimes a set with the element AR, like suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, are the that it is denoted by, like suppose A is a set and it there is a 4 different elements. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So here we can say that the element set AR, element set AR, and which numbers are the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. In this way we can spell out that things. The element set A have the following numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. Similarly, a binary number defined on a set element of S. Okay, and an example to condition the relation, suppose I say that A star B equal to C. So we say that a star is a binary operator. This is called as an operator. These are the variable elements. So A star is the binary operator. If it is specific, a rule finding C from pair A and B. We can say that to find out the value of C, A and B are the operand and the operator is a star. So star is not a binary operator. It's a, if A and B are a set of S, then while the rules find out the C is not set of S. What is the meaning of postulate? The postulate is a mathematical form of, postulate is a mathematical form of the basic assumption from the which it is possible to deduce the rules, theorems and properties of the system. So today we also discuss some common postulates or theorems. The most common postulate formulate the various algebraic structures are common postulate. Okay, so first common postulate is closure. So remember the thing, a set of S closed with the respect to binary operator. if for every pair of element S, the binary operator specifically rules for the obtaining the unique element of S. Suppose there is a natural number, set of natural number, suppose the set of natural number, it contains 1, 2, 3, 4, all natural numbers are there, is close to the respect to the binary operator plus sign. Okay, it is close to the binary operator plus sign by the rules arithmetic addition. This is called as an arithmetic addition. So, since A and B is a set of N, suppose A and B is a set of N, we obtain the unique C is a set of N by the operator A plus B equal to C. The set of natural number is not a closed with respect to the binary operator minus the rules. Arithmetic subtraction may cause the negative number. Suppose this addition is a closer this defined, but subtraction, remember that thing, the subtraction is rules is not closed with this thing. The set of natural number is not a closed, not closed for subtraction. How? Suppose the 2 minus 3 is equal to minus 1. So this is not a natural number of n. Okay. Plus sign is always a natural number plus second natural number, always the natural number. But the subtraction, if a minus b, if b is greater, the result is negative sign and it is not a natural number. Okay. So here we can say that 2 and 3 is a set of natural number n, but minus 1 is not a set number n. So in this way we can say that the closure rule is that whatever the combination or operator of two same set n, the result is same set. So it is a closure to each other, or the closer theorem is applicable. Remember that thing. Okay. Now, the second is a associative law. Second is associative law. A binary operator star on a set S said to be associative. Operator said to be associative whenever the definition is that suppose there is a three element X, Y, Z and it's a part of same set. So X and Y two element and Z is a third element. So here the operator star is there. So this will become the operator same like as if I change the position. Okay. How can I change? Just operator such as that, star operator, but first it is operate with the Y and Z and then the star operator is X. So the position might be anything for all X, Y, Z belongs to set S. So this could be associative. Whatever the sequence, the result remains same and it is a part of the S element, then we can say that it is follow the associative. And the third one is commutative. Today just I give you the introduction about that things, but later on we will discuss the same theorem is applicable for the binary or not. A binary operator star on a set S may be commutative whenever the operator gives the same result if I change the position of variable. A position of set variable the remain same, like S 23 into 5 equal to 5 into 23. Okay. Remember that thing. Next is a identity element, 4th. Identity element, the definition is that a set of A's said to be an identity element with respect to the binary operation star, that the result, there exists an element, one element E is exist in the same set with the property such like that E, one part of element S, operator with variable X, it might be position change, the result is always X for every X belongs to S set. Like a suppose a 0 is an identity element with respect to operator plus sign. Okay. Example, 0 is identity element for which operation? Plus operation. For plus operation. Okay, suppose integer I contained all negative numbers and all positive number. Okay, so we can say that any variable X with plus sign and identity element, whatever the position is changed, the result is always itself variable X. Okay. So 0 is an identity for operator 1 sign. If this identity element operate with this operation for any variable value, the result is variable itself. The set of natural n has no identity elements is 0 is excluded from the set. Remember that thing. But for this is for applicable for all element. It is not like as a only for few, but it may be for every X belongs to set S. Next is a fifth one is a inverse property. So inverse is a set F, a set as having an identity element E. Identity element E with respect to the binary operator star. With binary operator star is said to be a inverse whenever, for every X belongs to S is exit an element Y belongs to S, such that, okay, every X belongs to S, there exists, it generates the Y. Y belongs to S. How? So, suppose X and Y2 an identity element, so E is generate the identity element. Suppose the integer I with identity element E equal to 0 Okay. So an element A is minus A or plus A. Remember that thing. Okay. It is called as an inverse identity element. Suppose here I is an identity element for integer I equal to 0. The inverse element A is minus A. Okay. Like suppose A plus Y is an inverse element. Minus A, an identity element 0. So A minus A is equal to 0. So what, which one is inverse for A is minus A. Okay, and it is for this integer values. All negative and positive values are there. And the last basic theorem is distributive law. So distributive law is applicable that whatever the two binary operator, suppose I will take the dot and star sign, two operator is there. So if X is operated one with Y and second operator, Y dot Z, this is equal to first the operator is individually X star Y and X star Z, and both are results are operated with the second variable dot. Right? So this dot variable is convert here and it be distributive. It can be called as a distributivity. Is it? Suppose an example, the algebraic structure is a field. A is a set of elements and together with the two binary operator, each having the property 1 to 5. And both operators combine to give the property 6. The set of real numbers together with the binary operator plus and dot sign is there. Okay. Suppose here star, it convert plus and dot. So X plus Y dot Z is equal to X plus Y dot X plus Z. So it is called as a distributive. So from the field of real numbers, the field of real numbers is the basis of arithmetic and ordinary algebra. The operators and postulates have the different meaning. So the operator and postulate have a following meaning. So we take the one by one first. The binary operator plus defines addition. It look like as a similarly OR operation. Second, the identity, the additive identity. Remember that additive identity is 0. If we add any number with 0, the result is number itself. The additive inverse, the additive inverse define subtraction. X operator plus Y equal to 0, so Y is the inverse of X. Okay. The next is the binary operator dot defines multiplication. It is called as a dot sign. Sometime if there is no any variable, it is a blank space, it is also integrated by dot. Remember that thing, dot or blank space. And which one is the identity for multiplication? the multiplicative identity is 1. Okay. 1 dot x is equal to x dot 1 is equal to x. So it is a identity for multiplicative operator. Remember that thing. So identity is a different. Now the multiplicative inverse. The multiplicative inverse is equal to x 1 upon x. Okay, how defines x dot 1 upon x is equal to 1. So it is an identity element. So the inverse is 1 upon x. And the only distributive law applicable to which two variable dot over plus sign. How? Let's see. Suppose there is a variable, three variables there, A, B and C. Okay. And the operator dot B plus C, this will become A dot first B. Here dot sign is there. Again the bracket complete, then the second operator plus here, second bracket is there, A dot C. So this called as a distributive. This is applicable for dot and plus sign. Okay. But it is not applicable for the reverse order. Remember that thing. Okay. A plus B dot C is not equal to A plus B dot A plus C. Remember that thing. Okay. This is the wrong. In reverse order, it is not applicable. In this way, it is applicable. So, distributive law applicable that dot over plus, not plus over dot, dot over plus. So, note down that thing whenever distributive law is applicable. We will discuss the axiomatic definition of Boolean algebra in the next lecture, as well as the proof of each and every rules and theorems. So I hope, is it making sense? Whatever the basic definition of Boolean algebra which we discussed today, have a good day.